to always procrastinate? Is procrastination the same as laziness? But why do we procrastinate? Procrastination is an emotion regulation problem. Hello Philippines! Hello everyone! It's a lovely day to have a great life. Welcome to Emery Show. Do you always procrastinate? Is procrastination the same as laziness? Nope, they are very different. Procrastination in Latin verb is procrastinare, means to put off until tomorrow. The procrastinators choose to do something else instead of the task they know they should be doing. They have the desire to do the job, but they cannot force themselves to start. On the other hand, laziness is an unwillingness to act. Lazy people don't do anything and they are okay with it. Why do we procrastinate? According to Dr. Tim Pichel, a psychology professor and a member of procrastination research group at Carleton University in Ottawa, procrastination is an emotion regulation problem, not a time management problem. We procrastinate because it is our way of coping with challenging emotions and negative moods in specific areas like boredom, anxiety, frustrations, resentment, self-doubt, and beyond. So for example, I'm not good at this. I'm not smart to write this, or you don't think it's the best option. So how are we going to prevent or overcome procrastination? Of course, first, recognize that you are procrastinating. If you switch focus because you want to avoid to do something, then you are procrastinating. Second, work out why you are procrastinating. If you see yourself making excuses about not doing something, then ask yourself, why are you procrastinating? Third, adopt anti-procrastination strategies. Procrastination is a habit, so hindi nyo siya mabibreak overnight. Bad habits stop if you avoid practicing them. So you can try some of these strategies that I'll be sharing with you. First is commit to the task. Focus on doing and not avoiding. So list down the tasks that you need to complete and specify a time for doing them. Use Eisenhower's principle in your to-do list. Na-share ko yan in my previous video. I can share the link. It enables you to identify what activities you need to focus on and prioritize. Next strategy is reward yourself. Oh, I love this one kasi if you're able to complete the task on time, then reward yourself like buying a slice of cake or a coffee from your favorite coffee shop. Next strategy is monitor yourself. You can use an online tool or app like Procrastor to help you self-monitor. You can also use task and time management apps to help you be more organized, such as Trello and Toggle. I haven't tried those two, but when I search it, mukhang okay siya. It's a friendly one naman. Another strategy is act quickly. This one, I apply it to myself. So if there's a task that I need to do, ginagawa ko kagad. Kaya nga, act quickly. Do the task as soon as they arise rather than letting them build up over another day. Another strategy is master the scheduling and project planning. For your big project or multiple projects on the go but don't know where to start, these tools, the scheduling and project planning, can help you plan your time effectively and reduce your stress levels. Next strategy is minimize distraction. So as much as possible, avoid social media. Or better, turn off your social media. And avoid sitting anywhere near television while you work, especially those people who are working at home. Do the most challenging task at your peak times. When are you most productive? Do you work best in the morning, midday, or afternoon? At pag na-identify mo na kung saan ka mas productive and effective, that is the time you do the most challenging job. If you find your projects overwhelming, try breaking them into more manageable chunks. Or you can start with a task that you find least pleasant. Or yung hindi mo gustong gawin, or hindi mo feel gawin. So, yun ang umpisahan mo. It will give you the rest of the day to concentrate on work that you find more enjoyable. Yan, sometimes I do that as well. I do this strategy. So, if I find this unpleasant for me, so I yun yung inuuna ko. Then the rest, I can work na kung saan ako mas nage-enjoy. Or you can also start with quick, easy, and small tasks first. Small wins will make you feel more positive and less overwhelmed. And last strategy that you can try is set time-bound goals. Set yourself a specific deadline to complete tasks. It will keep you on track to achieve your goals. Now, if you decide to procrastinate because you are someone who thrives under pressure, please avoid putting your coworkers under any unpleasant and unwanted pressure. So make sure wala kayong dinadamay na coworkers na who doesn't like procrastinating. But I suggest you avoid procrastination. Why? Procrastination is a habit of delaying an important task and focus more on a less urgent and more enjoyable activities. Remember, procrastinating is one of the main barriers blocking you from making the right decisions. Restrict your potential, disrupt teamwork, reduce morale, depression, and job loss. Procrastination wastes your time that you could be investing in something meaningful and living the dream life you've wanted. Thus, it is crucial to take proactive steps and use appropriate strategies to manage and overcome them. I hope this helps you and you learn something new today. So let's have a reflection of the day. In your lifetime, have you ever experienced procrastinating but you wish you didn't do? Go ahead and share it below. If you enjoy this episode, don't forget to like this video and subscribe. Remember to always smile and stay gorgeous. Ciao!